Thanks very much, Manish, for joining in. Obviously, you know, the first off, the environment is, you know, very different from the last policy. A lot of favorable changes, be it on crude oil prices coming off sharply, almost 30% change in crude oil prices. The currency has strengthened. You know, we're looking good, at least even on the inflation side, which has come undershot the RBI's inflation expectations. So, you know, what is the expectation that you're having now? Are you also of the camp that believes that nothing much will be done this time around? It'll be fairly lackluster in terms of a policy.
Yeah, morning, Ira. It's, I completely agree. 2 months is a very long time in financial markets, and we have seen what has transpired. I mean, in October, we had a policy where the stance was changed, and there was a fear of a rate hike. And today, going into the monetary policy, The fortunes have completely reversed, in the sense rupee has appreciated, as you said, oil is down 30%. And there is a lot of clamor in markets that why to have the stance itself, you know, calibrated tightening, that could also come under question. So in my view, I think it's not something that I'm looking at today's policy that there would be, you know, it will be nothing much to watch for. In fact, it's a very, very important policy today, because In the backdrop of what has happened in the last few months in terms of the NBFC crisis, which hit the markets 2 months back, and the way oil has, you know, fallen off from the peaks, a lot of things have changed. A lot of projections which were done in the last policy might get revised. So in terms of, I think that the points to look forward to in the policy would be what is the inflationary outlook with the drop in oil prices, whether RBI actually lowers down the projection. I would say forward-looking, because quarter one 2019-20 was 4.8. So whether it is brought down or not, and they gave a further direction about what is going to be the next 6 month projection in 19-20. Second would be growth forecast. I think they have stuck to around 7.4 for the year, whether that gets revised down with the latest Q2 numbers available to us. Besides that, I think the third important point, if you look at the numbers, would be some kind of light if they throw upon the liquidity measures which they have been doing. They have already announced 1.75 trillion worth of OMOs in this fiscal, because if you see, the underlying liquidity situation has been pretty tight. So I think a lot of factors to look at, a lot of guidance to look at, but definitely I would expect that the stance would not get changed this time. It is a long-term thing which gets taken care of. It can't be changed every 3 months or 6 months. So I think no change in stance, but a lot of other numbers to be looked at in terms of liquidity measures, in terms of what they intend to do, in terms of supporting the credit growth to the sectors which are lacking. So I think it's not going to be a lackluster policy. It's a very, very important policy, which will lay down, I would say, the path for 2019.
Manish, you know, when you talk about the inflation, the October number came in at 3.3%, lowest since September 2017 on the back of the food inflation numbers. However, core inflation numbers at 6.2% still remain slightly more elevated. But then again, the MPC's mandate is the headline inflation, not the core inflation. But will that remain a slight bit of an overhang?
So yeah, you have a point. See, if you start looking at monthly numbers, then you are heading into a number for this month on 12th. It would be around something like 2.5%. So policymakers do not react to individual numbers. That is where I was mentioning that core is important, and the key to you know, today's policy is what is the kind of projection. Definitely, the inflation has undershot, as you say, in the last 3 to 6 months. And it is expected to stay benign at least for next 2 months at least. But then the key is what kind of headline inflation, as you said, headline is the mandate for the central bank in India. If it is going to be somewhere around 4.5 to 5 for the next financial year, and I think that is how the policy would get formulated, then I don't see a chance of you know, reversal of this stance, what market is clamoring for. But yes, if everything falls apart further, in the sense oil prices further go down and we do not see the expected food prices increases in the Jan to March quarter. If it nothing materializes, then you stand a chance. But otherwise, I think from a medium-term perspective, if you look at it, inflation expectations are around 4.5 to 5 for the next fiscal. And from that point of view, I don't think that RBI would immediately, you know, or in a span of 2 months will change its stance. Or should change its stance.
Sure, got that point. But, you know, I'm just trying to understand this a bit better because, you know, while we're talking about growth, which is likely to remain, and the rise in, you know, capacity utilizations, which are currently at 7-year highs, this will keep core prices elevated. The MPC in previous occasions has also expressed concerns of the rising household inflation in recent quarters. How does all of these elements weigh in?
Yeah, this is a tough one actually to reply to because the amount of data or the amount of noise which is there in markets and different data points throwing up different kind of directions. I completely agree with you that if you look at the household expectations on inflation, they are still quite high. The other thing is though the oil prices have fallen by 30%, but the pump prices have not fallen by more than 10%. So if you look at the overall inflationary expectations, they are not looking like that they're going down. They're going to go down so fast by household. The other thing is, which one has to look for, as you said, how is the industry doing? If you go by the credit numbers, we have seen one of the sharpest pickups in credit pickup, in credit growth in the last few months. This year, actually, the deposit creation is just 4 lakh crores and the credit creation is something like 5 lakh crores and investment is something like 1.25. So I think there is a mixed bag in terms of number. I frankly believe that the growth is somewhere going to be somewhere around, you know, 7.3 to 7.5 for the year, which is a very good number. And similar numbers are expected to be there for the next year also. In that backdrop, I don't see a reason RBI would be taking away, you know, the expectation in the markets is that this policy could turn out to be a bit dovish. But these are day-to-day markets which we look at. But from a medium-term perspective, I don't see a massive change in the policy stance today or even in the commentary today.
Manish, you know, just one more angle to the inflation. You know, we know that every $10 drop in crude oil prices has a 0.1, you know, percentage point impact on inflation. This drop in crude oil prices has been extremely sharp, and it's happened in a matter of a month's time, which probably indicates an additional dip of about 0.2 to 0.3 percentage points for the inflation reading in the month of November. Now that probably we will be seeing coming out, which will again bring inflation down that much more. So in light of that, the buffer or the cushion that RBI has, and whether or not they actually start looking at rate cuts, I mean, I'm just talking from a different angle here. Would you see that as a possibility?
Nothing can be ruled out. What you said, as I said, November inflation, the print would be somewhere around 2.5%. But I would actually be very, very wary of this kind of a hope of a rate cut in the near future. I think if that kind of a thing, you know, even if it has to be thought through, then it cannot happen before February, March, before we get some more data. You know, if you look at oil prices in isolation, I have agreed with you that prices have fallen and you would see some kind of impact on the fuel inflation. But the overall inflation, what we are talking about is, if we still have a trajectory of around 4.5 to 5 for the next year, then asking for a rate cut at this point of time, I think it is out of question at this moment. So I feel, you know, I can completely agree with you that there is a clamor for all, you know, for being very, very dovish and for a rate cut. But as of now, my personal view is that it is out of the table as of now. Yeah, they'll stay put, watch for more data. And I think anything of that sort, what you're asking for, could get considered in February, March, not before that.
Sure. My question was not related to this policy, probably down the line, once we get more data points nonetheless. But The other point now, as we're talking about other factors, providing a little bit of ease for the RBI, the focus now remains, and like you rightly highlighted in your answers before, is going to be on the liquidity side. They've highlighted 40,000 crores worth of OMOs for the month of December, that to come through. Do you see any sort of an impact on the CRR reading, whether there'll be any sort of an action on that, or the fact that they've already put out a calendar for OMOs, leaves that addressed, the liquidity side of it?
That's a very pertinent point, what you raised, liquidity. This year, if you look at how is the equation on liquidity panning out, the RBI intervention in the FX markets has led to a massive liquidity shortfall. That's around 2.1 trillion INR. And over and above that, the currency with public is expanding at a very, very scorching pace. This totaled around $5 trillion INR worth of liquidity getting drained out of the system. Against that, they have already announced and did OMOs. The total OMOs would be something like 1.75 trillion, what they have announced till December end. And the government balances drawdown has also added liquidity. But still, there is a massive shortfall of around something like 1 to 1.25 trillion INR, which is in the system. I believe that they would continue to address the liquidity with OMOs only. I do not see a CRR cut today. There is definitely a demand for that kind of a thing, and all those kind of discussions happen. But if you look at history for last 5, 6 years or 7 years, what we talk about, I think a lot of times the earlier RBI governors have also talked about prudence in terms of that this is the bare minimum of CRR which they would like to keep. I think it's from a macroeconomic prudential norms that CRR cut may not happen. They would address liquidity through the OMOs, which seems to be logical also, and it has worked pretty well because it supports the bond markets indirectly, and it takes care of liquidity part also.